Marxist philosophy is based on the concept of movement. Marxist, his own, if I know anything about it, understanding of the world is always in motion, in moving, always changing, and change is nothing to be sad about, or so. Also, nothing to enforce, because change is almost the same as life. Many of us, at least the typical ideology that perhaps most of us like, follow, develop, are somehow related to in a strong sense, is movement, but not as in Marxism, the dialectical movement. Movement in Marxism needs two extremes. And all movement, that's the most general concept of movement, all movement is the change, the permanent change, the back and forth between two extremes. The two extremes exert forces without any intention on that is in between, and that is the movement. The movement is being here and there, which you cannot be. You cannot be here and there in a physical sense, but in your thoughts you can, and that's movement. Thought is pure movement. We learn the opposite. Bourgeois ideology is the opposite of dialectical thinking, of thinking in extremes. Because there is one and only one principle in bourgeois view of the world, and that's profit. Just nothing else. And they don't even, Marx told them what profit is. They didn't know, the bourgeois economists. Profit in Marx is a not really important term. The term of surplus is the most important one. And surplus is that all capitalist production must produce. Surplus value. More to come out of work that went into it. And that's the surplus value. And when surplus takes on the form of money, say, that is very trivial, of your possession and so on, that's profit. Profit is the bourgeois form of surplus. Surplus is the essential form of what production is about. And I guess it's so, if anybody ever has a chance for some while, and not alone, but together with a small group, to try and understand, should I say Marxist philosophy? No, Marxist and Engels, I should always put the two together, view of economy, but of life as well, but of philosophy as well. In the division of labor between the two heroes, Marx was concentrating on economy and Engels on philosophy. But they always were working together. But they were intelligent enough to realize, look, if we really want to understand economics, then one of us must become really, really fit in it. And there is not enough power in an individual human being to do the same in philosophy, you know, in thinking. Therefore, this division of labor between the two, but always together. But therefore, the book Dialectics of Nature is authored by Engels, and the book Capital is authored by Marx. But it's their joint work. Fantastic lesson.